Now, I'm pleased to introduce an old friend, a great rabbinic leader, great communal leader, Rabbi David Algazi, the president of the World Committee for the Land of Israel. First of all, I want to tell you, my friend Paul Brody, who's chairing the concert May 23rd, said to me that you obviously are standing in the rain. So you are not, like President Obama, fair weather friends only. Thank you for being here. Your presence means a lot to the courage of the Jewish people. President Obama should know, and all the members of Congress should know, that the Jewish people are not silent, they are not dumb, they are not ignorant, that we are here and we will listen to what they say very carefully. It is incredible that after 62 years of the existence of a democratic, wonderful state in the world, the state of Israel, we are here today to speak about its existence, its rights, its opportunity to build in its own capital. And we are not here to say anything, but Israel is here, period. No, we are not. Listen to the president's parameters of where we can build. We are not going to give concessions to enemies who have vowed to destroy us. We are not to divide or surrender the capital of the Jewish people. We are not to give up Judea and Samaria, the land of our forefathers, where history was built to create a state that will destroy the Jewish people. And no President Obama, and no State Department, no, we are not going to die. It never again means anything. It means that today we need to be vigilant in the way in which the politicians of this country are playing with our interests. It is very nice to say we are with Israel. It is very nice to say I'm a friend of Israel. But when they propose a two-state solution, when they propose limits on the Jewish people's expansion in our own land, when they support our enemies, no, they are not our friends. Let us tell President Obama and the representatives of Congress that we are not going to stand by while they play with words and they hurt the existence of our State of Israel. It is difficult today, after 62 years, to hear a new narrative that the Arabs are the people of the land, that we are invaders in that land. It is difficult to understand the ignorance of the people of the world. We are here to remind the people. The Jewish people has been in the land of Israel 3,500 years, and we are not going to disappear. The Arab-Israeli conflict is not about territory. The Arab-Israeli conflict is about the destruction of any non-Islamic state in the Middle East. It is not about territory. Territory will not solve it. We want to have, our enemies want to have in Israel the return of refugees who are steeped in hatred, who dream, who were educated to dream of Israel's extinction. As Abba Iban so eloquently said, who would be so foolish as to bring hundreds of thousands of people and introduce them into a state whose flag they despise and whose existence they have vowed to destroy? This ignorance of Jewish history, the ignorance of Islam, the ignorance of what the Arabs are about to do has to stop. I was talking recently to a reporter who actually was here in our convention, in our demonstration. And he was saying that the land of Israel, that nobody will be able to survive unless there is peace. And I said, the only peace that the Arabs will accept is the destruction of the state of Israel, and that is not going to happen. But dear friends, I want to end with one thought. You know, the problem that we have in the world, the problem is the people who cannot accept that a conflict has no resolution. Not every disease can be cured. Not every social ill can be resolved. Not every problem can be fixed. Sometimes we have to learn that we are going to live with a problem and to be able to deal with it. Israel, America, the world has to accept the fact we have an implacable enemy, and that enemy is called Islam. Islam is not only a religion. Islam is a political platform to control the world. And I call upon the Christians of the world to realize, just like the Hindus are going to, there's Hindus and Sikhs here. They know what Islam can do when it takes over a country. So I say, let's wake up the world. Those who propose a two-state solution are proposing the suicide of the state of Israel, and they will not get it. The unfortunate problem is that we are not able to accept the fact that there will be no resolution to this conflict. Let us stand firm. Make sure that the Jewish people know, conflict or no conflict, we are here and we're not giving away. Thank you.